do like it.
Thank you very much. Yeah, it's definitely a different direction than what we originally intended to go in this band when we first started.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because you started writing very heavy in like the singer-songwriter kind of vein, and it's been a completely different vibe with you because you've been like you said, you've been focusing more on instrumentals. So right. They end up more like something like that, which honestly, in my mind, it tells its own kind of story. I've really enjoyed writing bass parts and rhythms to some of that music. That one especially, through my head, I'm playing the bass line in my head. Unfortunately, I didn't have time to stop and grab my equipment. I had to rush straight up from work in Canton. So it was a bit of a drive. It was a bit of a drive, so.
Yeah.
But that just gives you all a little bit more incentive to come out and check us out on New Year's Eve, right?
Absolutely. Yeah. I mean, I have a show on Friday. It's a solo show because, you know, I don't want to push Matt and break his hand again. Yeah, so we're kind of giving him another month off.
Ain't nobody got time for that.
Right. So he needs to recuperate, you know, properly. But I have two solo shows coming up, actually. The first one's going to be at Happy Dog at Euclid Tavern on Friday. It's with Not on the Daily and Steve Wright. It's free.
Free.
College kids, if you're listening and you haven't gone home yet for Thanksgiving. And
or watching in
plus hot dogs,
or you could be watching in.
Even the people watching right now online. Wait. You know, come out to the Happy Dog. It's in Cleveland. It's the one on the east side.
Whoa.
Yeah, it's a free show. And then Grog Shop on December 13th. It's a Tuesday and it's only $5, and that's with Old Brooklyn and Steve Wright again. I've been playing a couple shows with Steve Wright, and New Year's Eve, we're playing with our really good friends in Bad Wolf, which Ryan is also one third of that band
as well.
I'll be
pulling double duty that night.
He will be. Nice. Actually, back-to-back sets.
Nice. Thanks for the heads up.
So, eat your Wheaties that day.
Yes.
Well, you're not allowed to know. You're right. Supposed to, you know.
Well, usually.
The week before that we tell you, you know, so you're shocked.
The surprise is what energizes me.
Exactly.
You got to understand, not every time, but most shows that we play, you don't know when you're going on until you get there.
Mm-mm.
Or, like, 5 minutes before the doors open. Mm-hmm. You know, that's usually how it goes. And, like, it's nice having control over a show like this because I'm like, all right, you know, I know that this guy is going to open the show. I know that, you know, some people have obligations to go other places. So this band's going to play the 10 o'clock spot. This band's going to play the 11 o'clock spot. This band's going to play. We're having a solo guy. Excuse me, we have a solo guy called Nate LaPrairie. He's going to close the show for us. And, I mean, the dude can hold it down, man. He's awesome. He's got all types of jams that he does. Like, he's got solo and covers, originals and covers. He mixes it up. Then we have I Wonder, who is Mark Pethel. He's our former bandmate.
Mm-hmm.
He actually
holds down the jams.
Oh yeah. He's got a unique sound in his own, and it's really cool because he does a lot of stuff mixing it with timing.
Yeah, psychedelic blues funk prog kind of thing. It's
proc.
Yes,
that's a good definition of it. Yeah, I could definitely feel that.
Right.
But yeah, so there are many, many events to look forward to.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
We can play a song that we can sing. You want to sing a little?
Oh, jeez.
Yeah.
Yeah, let's do that.
Just in case, because I know I noticed one other issue. This is Map the World again.
Hey. Yes.
For some weird reason, the audio wasn't feeding for the first 3 seconds.
Oh.
So, yes, we are Map the World. Well, Cleveland and Akron, I suppose.
Cleveland and Akron. Yeah. Akron and Cleveland.
Clackron.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we're from Clackron.
I like these.
Or we're from A-Land? I don't know.
A-Land?
Alland?
No, A-C-Land.
Yeah, could be.
Cleveland, Akron? Yeah.
A Creverend.
Creverend?
Ah, Creverend.
Ah, Creverend.
So which one are you...
I don't know. Don't know. I was We could do False Prophet.
Sure.
All right, we're gonna play a song called False Prophet.
Okay.
And it's
Mike's gonna play, and I'm gonna pretend to.
Well, he's gonna sing along. We put this song on our EP, and on the EP, it's actually tuned two full steps down, so this is significantly higher, and this is the way it's played now, so I'd rather play it this way.
Thank you.
that's always a fun one for me to play. I love
it. Fun?
I love it. I love it. So what's up, guys? It's Thanksgiving tomorrow.
Absolutely. I know, and no one's alive in the chat.
They're all dead?
They're comatose from the turkey already.
Maybe.
They started early.
Or they're out hunting.
They could be hunting their turkeys. If they want a proper do-it-yourself Thanksgiving.
That's the way to do it.
They're probably out there right now.
Killing them a good American turkey.
Wrangling turkeys with their bare hands.
What is with them, like, dude, we're going to celebrate Thanksgiving by shooting Native Americans?
Whoa.
Like, that's what's happening up in the North Dakota right now.
Left turn to politics.
All right, let's stay away from that one. Well, it just makes me so angry!
But we dealt with politics for way too long.
I know. This has been a terrible year for everything.
I know.
A terrible year for the entertainment industry with all the people dying. You got to think about it. It's bound to happen. And it's going to be like that. Oh, 2017, it's terrible. Oh, Kanye died.
Predictions.
Nostradamus
over here.
First. The heart attack of a meltdown on stage.
It could happen.
So he's not going to run for 2020 president?
Oh, God, no, I hope not. I hope not.
That would be an interesting turn of events. My official stance on that would be that no one man should have all that power.
No. No, not at all.
It is what it is. You know. Like me, I'm just trying to stay out of politics whatsoever.
I agree. I know what you mean.
At 3 months of it, as bad as it was, it's like, yeah, no.
Right.
I'm done.
At some point,
give me though, like a half a year.
Politics just shows up on your doorstep, and sometimes you got to deal with it.
Yeah, and it's unfortunately that year for us.
This is that year.
Yeah. So, because I normally throw this question all over the place, beginning, middle, end, and that.
Mm-hmm.
So remember that I'm going to actually make you think.
Yes.
From a year from today. Where do you want to be as a band?
Where do we want to be as a band a year from today?
That's a great question.
Where did we want to be last year? Today. Where did we want to be today last year when we sat down at Mark's table and we came up with this whole idea? We were going to change the band name to Map the World, and we came up with this whole thing. It was like this day.
It pretty much was. It was around this time.
Yeah, it was like the day right before or after Thanksgiving.
Wow, that's kind of funny.
Yeah, so, yeah. I mean, what was our discussion then? Like, where did we want to be today?
Well, we were shooting for, like, touring the country kind of thing. Because also, coincidentally, 1 year ago, in November, you and I took that North Carolina trip.
That's right.
I was looking through my old Instagrams the other day, and I saw a couple of shots through the mountains down there.
Oh, it was great. And then we got really scared on the way down there, because, like, we ran into this wall of fog over this bridge across this mountaintop.
Yeah, in, like, West Virginia somewhere.
Jeez. Like, what are you going to do? Like, you sit there, or you drive through it, and you hope that you're not going to fall off the side of the cliff.
Mm-hmm. So we took it slow.
Yeah.
And we made it. Obviously, we made it. Spoiler alert. We're still here.
Well, I hope. Otherwise, this is really weird.
Yeah.
But yeah, I mean,
I would say, barring any other unforeseen injuries to band members,
right.
Ideally, we'd like to continue that path. I'd say, Mike was talking, we'd like to have that full-length album recorded by this point. And if we could be just starting to kick off, like, a tour, even if it's Northeast, East Coast, maybe Midwest a little bit.
Right.
Any of those areas. Just kind of getting about. Me personally, I would love to explore the country more and get to meet people in different states in those, you know, hole-in-the-wall bars that I hang out here in Akron and Cleveland. I want to see what that's like in other states. And I want to talk to people and get to know them.
It's a great thing you're in two bands.
Right.
So if you go on two tours a year, I mean, you're going to be gone all year. You won't be able to work anymore except for music.
Well, you know.
But at the same time, you'll be making money doing music.
Ideally,
yes. In 1 year, I want to at least have the band be self-sustaining. Something breaks, the band can pay for it.
A noble goal. Or the sponsor will pay for it.
Well, yeah. whatever. And I mean, how many bottles of cold cock whiskey can we?
That's our sponsor at the moment.
Can we break and have them replace? But yes, that is one of our sponsors, and it's that whiskey is great. By the way,
it's a delicious whiskey.
It is, American, and it's nice to
herbal infused whiskey.
It's nice to mix with LaCroix.
Mm-hmm. That's that sparkling flavored water stuff. In case y'all are unaware.
Yeah, I would.
It's a great mixer. We invented a drink called the cold cock or pamplemousse.
Yeah.
Or is it the cocky pamplemousse?
It was the cocky pamplemousse. Mm-hmm. Because it was really good. It had like mint leaves and whiskey and it was so good. Mm-hmm. But we need to have another party like that. Yeah. We have band parties at the basement bar. Mm-hmm. And we have darts tournaments, and it's just cricket, and we have drinking rules that get you wasted within like 20 minutes. But we have these parties, and we'll have all these different musicians come down and collaborate, and like we'll record the whole thing, and it's awesome.
Basically like an open jam night, open forum.
Yeah, like anything you want to do. Like, mm-hmm. I mean, I wouldn't care if somebody came down and like dictated a poem over top of whatever we were doing. Nice. Why not? Let's have some pros.
Mm-hmm. We'll have a reading of Pride and Prejudice while we play.
Absolutely. I know a few people that would be really into that, actually. And I think you do, too.
We're taking volunteers. Anybody?
Mark?
Right.
He'd be totally into that.
Holy cow.
Holy cow.
I was just trying to think. Trains of thought.
Cows.
We've leaped tracks.
We have.
Tracks. Yeah. Many tracks of trains of thought.
It's cool, though.
You lose track of the train.
It's cool. Do you want to hear some more music?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah. Maybe not right now.
Don't worry, I got some other different things.
He's going to keep us thinking. Keep our thinking caps.
Like,
on.
How about all this? 5 years.
Five years.
Where do you want to be in 5 years?
5 years. I would like to continually be touring. Hopefully we're playing larger stages at that point, larger venues. I don't know. There are a couple of songs that I really enjoy playing with the band. For example, False Prophet that Mike played earlier and that I sang horribly over. Y'all heard me. Usually I'm playing the bass and I'm not an intimate singer. But that song is so enjoyable. I've had visions playing that song on stage, like I can hear crowds roaring, chanting the lyrics, like singing with us, and it fills me with this excitement and this energy. That is what I want to be doing in 5 years.
And you know what the crazy thing is? When I introduced that song, I thought they were going to hate it. I thought they were going to hate it because it's about a conflicting faith idea. And we all have our own sense of faith, and none of them align exactly in the band, and I thought they would hate it, and they all three of them at the time they latched onto it, and it became one of our signatures, and that's why it ended up on the EP, really.
Nice.
Yeah, that's in 5 years. I mean, I agree with that. I think that in 5 years, that was a different man 5 years ago.
Right.
Like, I had a whole different life. I mean, that's a scary thought. That's a scary prospect. But
see, that's why I do it.
Yeah. Yeah.
The not clear 5 years from now.
I don't know.
To watch this.
In 5 years from now, I just hope to be playing music with my friends still. Ideally, yes, I would like to be doing this for a living for the rest of my life. But I mean, realistically, as long as they don't hate me after the next 5 years, then it's a win. I can be kind of, rough around the edges sometimes. It's usually a drunk thing, though.
Yeah, he's like a teddy bear made of steel wool.
Yeah. It looks cuddly, but once you get your face up on it, it starts to cut you up.
You break up a little bit.
Yeah.
I never expected that reference. I'm not going to lie.
There's something that just keeps you coming back.
Right. And it's and it's not the moldy smell.
No. That's me.
Yeah, did not expect that reference coming.
No. No, not at all.
Not at all.
Well, you gotta expect the unexpected. True. Keeping you thinking. Keeping you on your toes.
It happens, you know. But yeah, now it's your call. If you want to do another song.
I'm doing another song. Yeah, I got that other different energy things. Drink or, you know.
Well.
Well, you just get the energy to play, man.
Yeah. He needs rocket fuel.
I mean, it's a long drive to get over here. It doesn't matter where you're coming from. So like, when you're in construction traffic. I mean, it was construction traffic the whole way over here. Dude, I was going around Dead Man's Curve, downtown Cleveland, coming out here. And, like, some dude went from, like, I'm in the, like, second to left lane, okay? And I'm going, like, towards the lake to make the east turn to come out 90, okay? So some dude gets on the freeway and goes all the way across all four lanes to get over to the wall on the curve, okay? And some other dude X'd behind him in front of me to get over all the way over to the exit lane, like, as we're going around this, like, 95-degree turn on the freeway.
That's stupid. That's
so my God, dude. Just, people,
like, synchronized death machines.
Like, these old people talk about TVs like they're idiot boxes, dude. No. The idiot boxes are the cars on the road.
Yes, except these boxes contain the idiots.
Right, and they can kill you.
I see that a good percentage-wise. The only thing is, how do you best explain to people that walk out of a store don't look when they're just going to walk right out when cars are coming?
That's true, too. It's those phones. Those phones. Dadgum cell phones.
Common sense, man.
Like, a perfect example is when I was going home from here on, what was that, Halloween. Stop at a stop sign. Kid, he comes out. He sort of looked at the mother. She doesn't even look to see a car. Right.
If you are a parent, if you're a parent, get off the damn phone. Period.
Wait, is that on the list?
No, you're good with that.
Get off the phone. Watch your kid. I mean, I've seen kids just like head out in the middle of the street, and their parents just like, what? Just like looking at their hand. Right. Oh, dude, world star. Oh, look at my kid. He's so cool. He's playing in traffic.
Sadly, I guarantee that's out there someplace.
It probably. Yeah,
probably. That's the sad part. It's hilarious to think about. It really is, but.
Second grade Frogger competitions.
Yeah, if you look up, you know, hashtag, you know, played in traffic, it's probably out there.
I'm gonna do that.
Oh, man.
Find out.
Hashtag growing up stupid.
I bet it's out there.
Oh, man.
I would be shocked. By the way, it's Mike there.
There is a mic there.
Mike, there's a mic there.
What should I play?
Should
I play this box?
You could play this box. Oh, yeah, because we got to save Aquanaut for later. A little bit later down the line.
We could do Aquanaut now.
This box. Aquanaut. How much time do we have, actually?
We got time.
We got time for a couple songs. We'll play Aquanaut.
Sure. Especially because we're doing a fantasy.
Oh, wow.
At 5:45, so a little bit before then, had to stop.
Nice.
What?
An on-air fantasy draft?
Yeah. So have over an hour from now. So it could go about near 5:30.
Let's find out. We'll just wing it and see.
I guess we will wing it and see.
And don't worry, I'll make sure to check out the hashtag.
This is Aquanaut. This also made it onto our demo EP. Called Drarts, because
we, like,
we were so obsessed with that game for so long. I mean, we were drunk for like 4 months straight. Another window in time to peer straight through to a world so impossible the humanity will lose. Bury me up to the neck with sand.
And now I'm breathing this toxic ocean. Oh, you have the upper hand. I'll be back soon. This ocean floor won't be my tomb. You set me free from all my misery. Salty lies, sunken ships. You'll lose your eyes, your tongue and lips. Still I miss you so. Travel through this wasteland or fleeting black abyss. The danger lurks beneath me. Is there a point I miss? I figured out the meaning of this journey long ago. And now I've ruined everything and given up all hope. I'll be back soon. This ocean floor won't be my tomb. You set me free from all my misery. Salty lies in sunken ships. Lose your eyes, your tongue and lips. Still I miss you so. Set me free from all my misery. Salty lies and sunken ships. You lose your eyes, your tongue and lips. Still I miss you so. Still I miss you so. Still I miss you.
Nice.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Don't worry, it's actually out there.
Oh, no!
Not only they actually have videos.
Oh, jeez.
Except it's some fake ones. See, I told you, looked it up. See, there's a will, there's a way.
Absolutely. When you are determined, if you believe you can achieve, even if it's looking for Instagram content.
I mean, is that what you've been doing these days? You haven't been calling me that much. You just, like, sitting around on Instagram all day?
Are you talking to me?
Yeah, you?
Yes.
Yeah, because he calls me so much.
He might. Just saying. I don't know your life. I thought you guys were BFFs. A-E. A-E.
Cray.
You need more hobbies.
I do need more hobbies. I need more bands. Two is not enough.
Yeah, you need 14. Four. 14.
We need 14 of the bands.
14 team.
14 team?
14 team. You forgot the sh.
14.
14.
So I started writing a new post-rock song yesterday.
You didn't even tell me about this.
Yes. So this is a...
Well, you're too busy to Instagram.
That's right. True.
He is way too busy for this.
Trapped in the void.
So I'm going to play a little bit of the new song, give you an idea of, like, what the new stuff is.
Hashtag, oh god.
Too
busy.
Busy for this. Too busy for this. Thank you. that.
I like that a lot.
Yeah, yeah.
Definitely do like that. Would be interesting. Yeah,
there's a lot of potential for that.
That's kind of the direction that we're heading in right now. Mm-hmm.
That has a that gives me a feeling of brand new.
Like yes.
I feel a lot of brand new in that one.
Yes. That was, dude.
In a way.
God, I haven't listened to them in so long. And, like, that was, like, a very small pocket of my life was listening to, what was the one album?
Deja Entendu.
Yes. Just destroyed that album one time, dude, and absolutely. Just, like, never listened to it again. But it stuck with me.
Absolutely.
It then definitely you play stuck. Backwards.
Oh, my gosh. That would be sweet. I'm going to have to look into that.
What?
Just playing that album backwards. Why not?
Be crazy. Oh, no. Just
need to get a
mind.
Vinyl.
Yeah.
Yes. Just get a vinyl copy and put my record player on reverse.
Yes.
Yeah, I decided I'm just going to randomly make it up. Yeah, just listen to it backwards.
Why not? I'm all for it. Experimentation with music. You never know where you're going to find the next inspiration.
Right. Dude, listen to this, man. I recorded this one song. It was supposed to be just like a little interlude, like a 20-second guy, you know, just to like fill some time. And I recorded it. I'm like, all right, cool. Yeah, this sounds cool. And okay. I accidentally flipped the audio backwards. I'm like, oh, crap. So I, like, go back to do it. I'm like, wait a second. I kind of want to hear it. Dude, it's way cooler backwards. Way cooler backwards. I'm like, dude, had I not made a mistake, I would have never, ever heard that. Never known that I could have played that. Never known that that was what I was playing, just backwards. And it was just, like, way cooler.
There you go.
Damn.
So your advice is in good faith.
Yes, absolutely.
Huh. I never thought that would be,
right?
In all honesty.
Yeah.
Yeah, because, like, dude, when do you listen to your own music backwards? You don't.
Not really.
Unless it's an accident. That's well, exactly what happened.
I'm just into that kind of thing.
I never listen to anything backwards, so.
It's
there's
weird.
There's some beautiful secrets on some backwards albums.
Dude, right? We should listen to Buckethead backwards.
Buckethead backwards?
Or, like,
The Beatles backwards.
Yeah, we can
there's
do
plenty
that.
Of that. Plenty of that going on.
Yeah.
The whole Paul is dead thing.
Yeah, I heard about that. Like, I never heard of it till what was it? 4 weeks ago someone was telling me
really?
About it? Yeah, I never heard of it till recently.
There's a conspiracy theory that Sir Paul McCartney, is actually a replacement, and the original Paul McCartney had died back in the late 60s or early 70s.
They said that about one of the kings right before Queen Elizabeth II as well. Mm-hmm. So it's like that's a huge thing in England is like people replacement.
Replacing dead people?
Yeah. Hmm. That's like one of their big conspiracy theories is like, oh, we replace people. All right.
Mike's the authority.
I mean, dude, they replaced Amy Winehouse with
Adele.
Adele.
Mm. What? But she's not, it's not like Adele is
well,
Amy
no,
Winehouse.
No, it's Amy Winehouse minus all the drugs.
Mm.
Like, true. That's what they did. They replaced Amy Winehouse.
Yeah. Don't get me wrong, I like Adele, but Amy had soul, man.
I know.
She had depth.
True.
She had some visions.
Drugs. Most definitely. You would.
Mm-hmm.
So. Yeah, so about that tour.
I was going to say, I see the gears turning. He's going to ask us another question.
Oh, yeah, I was going to go into that.
Let's do it. Let's hear this.
So, with where you guys want to go, let's say you had a choice of any venue within the U.S. or the world that you wanted to play at.
Oh, man.
What would be the dream place that you would want to?
Holy cow.
What's that? I either want to play at the Whiskey or... At what's that huge place? That huge arena in Amsterdam. God, I'm not even sure. I know that there's a huge arena at Glasgow. That
it's not Wembley, is it?
I don't know, is it?
Glastonbury. Mm-hmm. No, I'd like to play both of those.
I just know that wherever there's gonna be a ton of people. I don't care where it is. I don't care if it's your backyard, dude. You put some people back there, I'll play. I don't care. Like, and I had a conversation with my grandma not that long. Well, I mean, I say not that long ago. It was like a decade and a half ago.
Jeez.
So
in the grand scheme of things, it's not that long ago.
It really doesn't feel like that long. But I was talking to her about, because I've been playing music since I was like 9 or 10.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and I've been playing guitar about just as long. And I've been playing shows since I was about 13.
Mm-hmm.
And I've been recording since I was about 13. So, like, I was talking to my grandma one day, and she is like, you're living your dream. You're having so much fun. I'm like, no, I'm not living the dream. I'm like, I'm not a rock star. I'm not doing any of that. You know, I don't have my bus or any of that. She's like, no, you are on a stage. It doesn't matter if you're playing to one person or 100 people. You're living your dream. So that's really all that matters. And that's why I said earlier, like, my five-year goal is just to, like, hang on to my friends. Like, because I'm already living my dream. I'm in a radio studio right now. There are people on the internet listening to the music that we're writing. You know, like, that's all I care about. I just want people to hear what I have to say.
Absolutely. Valid. I like that. That's some solid advice to keep in mind.
Absolutely. Stay humble. Yeah. Like, we're in a cutthroat business here. I mean, even on your end.
True.
Like, dude, I was in radio. It's a cutthroat business. Somebody will destroy your whole life for your job. And it's the same on our side.
Oof. Like, valid.
Gotta watch out.
So, I mean,
except we're stay more a little humble. Bit
support your local bands. Support the people that are in your community.
Absolutely.
I mean, even down to, like, local businesses. Like, stay local.
Like this beautiful establishment here that is supporting local bands?
Right, exactly.
All you, like, beautiful listeners out there, support Lakeland Radio, Lake Effect.
Dude, so, even Starbucks was local at one point.
Yeah, that was true.
At one point.
I just did a discussion board on that for class about that.
Nice.
About Starbucks.
Oh, yeah?
Small world. Yeah, whoever thought, you know, a week later, yeah.
Everything comes back full circle, man. I think it's weird because I'll think of something at work and then, like, oh, that hasn't happened in a while. And then it happens, like, 20 minutes later.
Mm-hmm.
You know? It's like, once you're on that vibe, man, it just, everything mm-hmm. starts coming back full circle.
Like, the funny thing, like how I was telling you before we started that we have an app and now it's in the Android market.
Yeah.
If you go down here, local bands, artists, and all that, click on that, and go through, it's everybody's like pages.
Nice.
It's been here.
Dude, yeah, you can check out this app. Lakeland's got this app, and they have all of the band pages.
Like that.
Nice.
Very cool.
He just, like, went on his app and pulled up Goodnight Tonight's Facebook, like, immediately.
You guys are in here.
Yeah, where could we go to download that app?
Just in the Play Store?
Oh, yeah, Play Store.
Google Play Store.
Yeah, Google Sweet. Play Store. Yeah, you guys are in here.
And look up Lake Effect Radio.
Station, yeah.
Lake Effect Radio Station.
Awesome.
There you go, folks. That's how you do it. Now get to it.
Now I just had to find you guys. That's the bad thing is, because I can't actually go by alphabet and all that.
Yeah.
So it was going on a like page, going of who we liked and just going from there from top to bottom.
Oh, yeah.
Because if I sat there, it had... Because it's, I think, like over 80-something people in here.
Oh, really?
So you just imagine that. Try to go and actually go by alphabet through there placing. God, that would be a bad thing.
This means you might find something you didn't know that you liked before.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, I'll you guys are actually underneath...
There we
you
go.
Guys are actually underneath Goodnight Tonight.
Very cool. Look at that.
Right under Goodnight Tonight.
Yeah.
It's perfect.
So, yeah. Not many people know about that, except you guys.
Yeah. Well, hopefully all your listeners now do. We just plugged it.
Yeah,
well, no,
we did just
the
plug
actual
it, so.
Local bands. Yeah, no one knew about that.
Oh, really?
Oh, that was the last minute
feature. You should put out a blast,
feature.
Man.
Yeah, we'll start talking about it.
Yeah, that was the last minute feature of when I was doing it.
Oh, okay.
They didn't say anything like Mike McFarlane. He's in there.
Yeah.
The only bad thing is...
He's right there, too. On his cool guy motorbike.
Because I know he knows him in that. The only bad thing is, here and there, because you only have 15 characters, some people I had to leave the space out of their name or...
Oh, yeah.
Like him, because how long his name is, so it's no space and it's missing a D.
Michael McFarlane.
Yeah.
Michael McFarlane.
Not intentional.
Not or like intentional. Keys and Corridors. I heard you have a a Keys and Corridors ad. It's pretty cool. Like this is like all airtime? About local.
Like I love it. They're in there.
Very cool. Very cool. Well, one I know away. We definitely appreciate the opportunity to be here.
Do our
by the way.
Yeah.
We are, for those of you just joining us, we are Map the World.
We are Map the World. I am Mike Sandy. This is Ryan Kubilis.
I am Ryan Kubilis. This is Mike Sandy.
All right. I play guitar. He plays bass.
And what he said.
Yeah.
I'll play backwards.
Yes.
There you go. We're on to something.
Oh, man.
No, we were actually, we were kicking around an idea. What was it, like May or June when we went to that Datsik concert? We wanted to, like,
oh yeah,
implement dubstep into our music.
Well, we wanted to almost start a side project.
I know, like dude. And like, I started coming up with
electronic music side project.
Yeah, and I started coming up with these beats and sending them out to them, and like, that stuff is so hard to do. It's so time consuming.
Because the thing that we wanted to do was, besides just making the beats, like we wanted to start them on some sort of, you know, digital audio interface. Okay. But we wanted to be able to perform it live instrumentation. So which live is drums, live keys and synth, live guitars, you know, whatever.
In the like the crazy bass distortion that you need to, like, I can't remember what it's called.
Just get like super wobbles.
Yes.
Super wobbles. It was kind of interesting. At one point, I had found a, it was a piece of equipment for your bass. It was almost like, if you ever played the original Nintendo back in the day, in the 80s, the NES, the power glove that you would wear. It was almost a power glove for bass.
Oh, yeah, I remember that.
That you could, it detected your motion, and it was almost like you were playing a theremin with your bass. So you'd get the wobbles with your hand movements like this. And then you could come back and slap, pop, and actually play the notes.
Huh.
And then just like, boom, chicka bow, bow, whoa, 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 boom.
Never thought of that. Say, so seen a power glove, because the one guy, he does video game remixes and comes in here.
Yeah.
Never thought of that in the actual music while playing.
Now, I'm not sure where to get that equipment anymore. I just saw it on a random video, and I searched and searched because I was like, I need this in my life. I need to play bass like this.
I need this $1,000 glove in my life.
But I can't find it. I might have to just build it. I don't know how to build
it. Come on,
it,
Tesla. Get on it.
Well, it has to be some kind of prints out there someplace.
That's true, actually.
Just have to Google it.
That's true.
Someone probably came up with how to build it and all that, you know?
And you just proved playing in traffic, if that's out there, well then this equipment has got to be out there.
No playing in traffic. If you're going to play in traffic, make sure your mom's not staring at her phone.
Mm-hmm.
Speaking of full circle, stay off your phones.
That's overrated. Like, you know, why, you know, if you're in the middle of a store, why, you know, stand in the middle and take up the whole aisle? Then go grab something.
Yes.
It's not like anyone else wants to come down the aisle.
Absolutely not. Don't even start. I work in retail, so I understand.
Yeah, that's no good.
Oh, geez, that just reminded me. Not only is tomorrow Thanksgiving.
Friday is.
Black Friday.
That's horrible.
It is. But I am playing a show at the Happy Dog in Cleveland.
It'll brighten up your Black Friday.
Not just
a little bit.
The Happy Dog. It's the Happy Dog at the Euclid Tavern. It's on the east side. It's not the west side one over by West 54th. It's not that one. Mm-mm. It's on the east side.
Mm-hmm.
At the Euclid Tavern.
Yeah.
And it's with Steve Wright and Not on the Daily. And Not on the Daily, I think it's just two dudes.
They're not there all the time, but.
Yeah, just. They're there, just not on the daily. Ah!
Ooh. I love those kind of names that you can think of. I definitely appreciate those names.
The classic one is Free Beer.
Yes.
I feel like.
Yes. Like,
that's the best and worst band name all at the same time.
If I ever, ever find somebody in a band called Free Beer,
mm-hmm.
I'm throwing them through a brick wall.
Right. Because like, imagine if you see that on the marquee, right? Saturday night.
Free beer.
Free beer.
It's packed full of 1,000 people, and you have to pay $5 a beer and wait 2 hours in line.
Jeez.
Mm-hmm.
Like a wanted interesting band I ended up finding once. Try to get them to come in. Redneck Incorporated.
Interesting.
I mean, literally, isn't that an interesting name?
Yeah.
Curious about their business model there.
Well, it's probably some sort of Southern flag. Or Don't Tread on Me. And a Chevy.
What was the other one?
And some Skull or Copenhagen. That would be my guess.
It was another one that was like really out there that it's like, wait, what? I'm blanking on it. Darn. Well, because like here, like he knows, we here and there do the spotlights, taking everyone's tracks, adding in the beginning, then add in, you know, artist, band name, then the track and that. Here and there you had the groups like Dead Gumbies. They actually have a song named Dead Gumbies.
Nice.
So you had to repeat it twice.
Dead Gumbies with Dead Gumbies. Oh, man.
Yeah,
like
top
Boston in Boston, right?
Boston in Boston.
Yeah, Boston has a song called Boston.
What was it? Top Black Hat had a song after their name that same. So you think, say that twice, not including that sounds like, you know, already a handful.
You got to be very limber in the vocal region.
Literally.
Yes. Mike sounds like some he's interesting a little bit.
No, I'm just kind of offering some...
some beautiful ambiance.
Some ambient tone. Ambient tone.
Ish.
I hope everybody out there is enjoying themselves. I know I certainly am. Enjoying myself and themselves. And yourselves.
Are you enjoying yourself while they enjoy themselves?
I'm enjoying ourselves.
All right.
Yes.
With yourselves.
With yourselves. And yourself.
True.
Absolutely.
But maybe I'm a figment of your imagination.
Hashtag figments.
It's hashtag failure.
So my one next thing of... where do I want... do I want to go there?
I don't know. Do you want to go there?
Maybe...
do you? Do you want to go there?
If you had to pick... let's... say, sir, went beginning of the semester with this. Let's say... you were at a main attraction of... a national... event... who would you want to open for you?
Nice. Anybody?
Anybody. Local wise, you know, mainstream.
I'm trying to think. That's tough.
I know.
That's like the reverse question.
Yeah, because usually...
it's like, who do you want to open for?
Yeah. Who would you most love to play with? Like,
now you're actually opening for somebody.
Oh, please, let me grace the stage that somebody else is gracing too.
But here we're like,
right, this is going to be either the real kind of ass answer or one. Like, oh, yes, I want Tool to open for us. Tool fans are just idiots.
Didn't mean that. Oh, man. Gosh.
See, I told you I was going to make you think.
You did. I didn't believe you, but...
if I was on a national stage, I'd want to take my friends with me. Especially if it was my first time. Like, I'd want to... especially the bands that, like, we've gotten close to over the past even year or... because Ryan and I have been playing music together for like 4 years. A couple of different bands. I mean, we've met a lot of people, you know, over these years. And I think the ones that we've grown closest to, I'd want to, I mean, I don't even want to say have open for me or us or whoever it may be. But I definitely want to share in that with them. I wouldn't want to do it alone. That would.
And that, folks, is the humble answer.
That's the truth, though, because, like, dude, I wouldn't want to, especially if it was, like, the first time being a national act somewhere, like, I wouldn't want someone that's been a national act somewhere for 10 years opening for me.
It might steal the show.
either that or like it would throw me off my game. Like, oh, I've been listening to them for years and they killed it tonight. You know, it's shit, like
energizing. Your power level should be over 9,000 at that point.
Well, one could hope.
Yeah. It's over 9,000.
So he gave the humble answer.
So you're going to go reverse?
Yes. I'm going to throw out there, also because I think it might make you smile. I'm going to say Metallica.
Oh, my God.
Metallica?
Oh, my God.
Oh, man. Mike is not a fan of Metallica. And I think it would be pretty interesting to see them knock down a peg a little bit. And we're like, you know what?
Okay, I'll give you that. I'll give you that. I really, really, really hate Metallica. And it's not because it's not because they're less than cordial people. Mm-hmm. And I say that because I can't call them when I want to on the air. But
that's right, the list is on the wall.
The list is on the wall, and a lot of the words I want to call them are on that list. Mm. But I'm sick of hearing the same goddamn thing for 20 years. Really? 30 years. It's the same music over and over and over. And then you had Saint Anger, that piece of crap. And then that flops. And they put out, what was it, Death Magnetic after that. Yeah, and that had Unforgiven 3.
Yeah,
over three decades, you put out three parts of one song. Over 30 years.
It was a little unnecessary.
Fallon.
Stop with the music. If you ever hear this, which is 100% unlikely, please stop. Please. Did you see that meme? Where it's like... they sent Metallica, I can't remember the name of the album. It's like, hey, God. I loved this album. They're like, oh, we didn't make that one. It's like, yeah, I know. You don't make albums this good.
Oh, wow. Burn. James Hetfield is out there right now, and he's just fuming.
That's fine.
Lars Ulrich put a hole through a wall.
Well, I mean, dude.
With your picture Lars, on it.
Lars can't hit his drums right, let alone a wall.
Ouch.
There it Man, oh man. Oh, there are man. Many who would say
fired.
That. Right. There are many who would say Lars is one of the most reliable drummers in
cuz he doesn't do moment. Anything technical. He has like been playing the same thing since he was 12.
Yeah. We're getting down to the heart of the matter here now, folks.
I hate Metallica.
Yeah, it's really
I like
hatred.
Megadeth.
There you go.
Megadeth is great. Okay. I'm not a Metallica fan. I was for a minute. Because I was born in the late 80s, mm-hmm. You know, my mom was, you know, she was into all that 80s crap. She listened to Metallica, Megadeth, and all that. So I got into it a little bit, but the only thing that I can say that I really like from the 80s at this point is, like, Megadeth and Van Halen. Van Halen's awesome.
Yeah.
I get a lot of inspiration from Eddie Van Halen because he invented tapping. Like, the dude... invented tapping, and Steve Vai just, like, exploded it and made it what it is.
I didn't know that.
Yeah. Eddie Van Halen was Fact the first check. One. Well, I mean, he was the one that, like, mainstreamed it.
I could see that, though. That was a wild man on the guitar.
Nice. Oh, yeah. But other than that, 80s kind of sucked. Mm. I'm so glad I skipped it. Like, if I could go back to any... okay, I have a question for you.
Okay.
If you could go back to any time period in the world and anywhere in the world during that time period, where and when would it be?
Hmm. Damn, that's
you can tell a lot of things about a guy, depending on what he says.
Mm-hmm. I got my answer.
I do, too.
Kid first came, it was like, boop.
I'm sort of thinking of multiple different ways.
Right. You can go literally... anywhere.
I want to be in 1960s Baltimore.
Well, I would.
No, you don't.
All right.
No, you don't.
I would have to go back to big times of when AC/DC, Boston.
I mean, anywhere in history. Time. Anywhere in history. Not even music history. I'm talking about like
the zero mark.
Yeah.
Well, I don't really care about. I would go back to near that time.
Mm-hmm. Okay. What's your answer? Where would
My
you?
Answer?
Where and when?
Not really, a little bit for the music, though.
Oh, definitely. I can feel that. This mine is a little bit different than
like
the
music. You got the TARDIS. You can go anywhere.
Probably feudal Japan.
Okay.
I would say. I don't know. Gosh.
Like 500 years ago?
No, probably even longer. I've always been interested in samurai and like it's an interesting thing. I've been interested in European knight culture, like royalty and knights and valor and honor, but the samurai they exhibit those attributes to a T. And
did you know that
incredibly interesting.
All samurais worked alone and they were hired hands and only rich families could hire them.
Those were the Ronin. Those were the samurai who did not fight under any feudal lord.
So they actually had armies of samurais?
Yes. The feudal lords, the people who owned the the feudal lords. You have all the land you own, you rule over the villages basically.
Right,
you
it's were like main an earldom in England.
Yes, exactly. You were the main dude, and then all these samurai basically pledged themselves to you and they fought and followed with you. And if ever your feudal lord died or was murdered or anything, if you weren't able to go out and wreak vengeance upon those who took him out, you became a wandering Ronin. Were you just a lordless samurai? And bada bing, you're a hired hand. You go out, work for rich families, or just do random
somebody
acts
hires
of justice.
You for like they would hire him for like a week. For like field work or a year for bodyguard or whatever, you know, like it wasn't like, oh, you're going to come in and live with us. It was like, no, you're going to like stay away, but you're going to do our work for us. And it was like, I don't know. I don't know as much about feudal Japan as he does. I know a lot about like medieval England.
That's my second choice.
Yeah. Medieval England would be mine because, if you trace my ancestry back, Grace O'Malley was my great, 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 whatever aunt. And she was the pirate queen in Ireland. And she fought against Queen Elizabeth I's troops with her people to try and get them to leave Ireland alone. And I think I would go back to that time period, I think just to help, honestly.
Mike just wants to be an Irish pirate.
Yeah. I want to be an Irish pirate.
Drink whiskey on a boat all day.
That would be amazing.
It happens.
Amazing.
I can believe it.
You know, there's a castle over there with my name on it.
Probably. There probably is a sandy castle over there.
See, I'm making fun of myself. Man.
I didn't even... Wow. Hashtag sandy castle. Whoa, look at the camera.
Whoa! So we were going to this Datsun concert, right? And I'm like, looking out the window, I'm like, whoa, look at that telephone pole. Whoa, look at that. I don't know. And like, dude, I geeked out so hard in the back of this car. And I almost pissed myself laughing.
Over a trash can.
Over a trash can.
Oh my God.
No, we were going to, okay, that's what it was. We were going down to Cincinnati. And we were going through the plains, like right through mid-Ohio. And there were like these 70 mile an hour winds because we had to go to the show out there. And dude, with all the equipment in the back of this car.
Yeah.
Oh, I mean, we're just getting pushed over into the other lane. Mm-hmm. And then we get boxed in by all these semis and finally we're like stable. But these semis are like tipping over like right next to us.
Their butts were swinging.
Oh, yeah, dude. I mean, it was scary. And then this trash can just, like, floats across the frame. I'm like, whoa, look at that trash can! And that's where that came from. Yep. Yeah, the end.
And now, you're in on the joke.
But, I mean, holy crap. That was a long ride down to Cincinnati for... Mm-hmm. I mean, there weren't a lot of people there, but it was a fun night anyway.
Definitely.
It was a fun night. We got to stay in a mansion. We had a mansion for us.
Airbnb is an amazing
like
thing.
This promoter like bought us this mansion for the night and like bought us this huge bottle of liquor, like not cheap. It was like an $80 bottle of liquor and he just handed it to me. He's like, here, hold on to this and take it back to the house. I'm like, okay.
You can't argue with that.
Right, I took it back to the house, and like there was one other band that stayed down there with us, and we all stayed up, and we drank the crap out of that bottle, man.
And ate a lot of Taco Bell.
We did eat a lot of Taco Bell. We did. I mean...
Well, you know, what else do you do?
Right, and then I ended up staying up until like 8 in the morning talking to the promoter, like smoking cigarettes in the basement, and I feel like I wasted that entire night. I could have slept.
Yeah, in this amazing, like,
but it's one of those things that happens.
Story,
dude. We got Ryan and I stayed in the same room, right? Because there, I mean, there's like 15 to 20 rooms in this place. I mean, it's huge. So we find this room, and there's like a futon couch on either side. It's like this movie screening room, like on the top floor. And we look at each other, and like there's a bathroom attached to this room. I'm like, dude, this is us. He's like, yeah.
Movie posters right, all on the walls, like original cinema posters.
Like, this place was decked out, dude. And like, I think we ended up watching like Judge Judy all night.
Yeah. Till we pass out on the futon.
In this nice ass movie room.
You're just like, eh.
Yeah, it was definitely an experience. I'm glad that we went down there. I really am. So we played a decent show the night before, and then we had to go to Cincinnati the next day. And it was fun. It was really fun.
Definitely worth the experience. Kind of a little taste of that touring life, you know?
Because we haven't really gotten a chance to do that yet. And that's really why I want to push for this album to be done in the fall next year. So, you know, I can spend the winter, you know, kind of setting up for the tour that comes right after that. So I want to do, obviously we have to do some sort of anniversary show every year. We have to. I know Matt doesn't like it because he doesn't like playing shows on New Year's, but I mean, it's kind of our thing now. But I think that once we get this new album done and mastered and finally have something completed that is real, you know, and not just something that we put together really quick in the basement just so we had something to pass out to people, you know, something that's a true
there,
right, like a true depiction of what our art actually is, then I will be happy enough to be able to do that. I feel like we need to work kind of like a country. You work at home first, you work on your infrastructure, you work on your product, you work on, you know, you find yourself, and then you go out and do your thing. True. You know, I don't want to, you know, you can't be a salesman with an empty briefcase.
That's a good point. You got to have a product to sell.
Right.
Yeah.
And I'm not even saying to sell. I just want it out there in people's hands. Like, dude, if I have to spend 10 grand on a CD that we're only going to get $5 a piece for, cool. Whatever. Don't want to do that. But as long as people are listening to it, I don't care. I don't care. I just want people to hear it. Because when I was a kid, my only wish was to be immortal. You know where I got that from? Vegeta. I got that thinking from Vegeta. I just wanted to wish from Shenron for immortality. And the only way I can think of to do that is through painting, which I suck at. My little brother's phenomenal. Like a realism artist. He's great. Or music. I can do stick figures in like Cartman type, Cartman type characters, like with the round head and the fat body, and like I can't do art, I do music, and that's where the immortality is going to come from.
Music is an art.
Yeah.
Yeah.
For your ears.
It's an art for your ears.
For your ears.
It's a treat.
I wish you could smell music. A lot of it would smell like probably cocaine and hookers.
Fun fact. You can smell music. I took a trip down to Nashville last year, and I visited Jack White. So he's got a record store slash his whole record store, recording studio, venue. It's called Third Man Records. They have all kinds of vinyl up on the walls because Jack White and their company presses vinyls. They had one there that was a pink-scented vinyl, and it... So when you play the vinyl, somehow it releases
the scent. It scrapes off the powder or whatever it is.
Into the air. And it was
That's awesome.
It was some indie artist. I forget her name, but it was an indie artist.
Puts and perfume it was, in it. Or yeah, whatever.
It was like floral perfumey, and whenever dude, you play the music,
brilliant.
You'd smell it.
That is brilliant.
They had all kinds of sick, crazy vinyls. That was just like what?
Because your sense of smell is your strongest memory.
There you
That's
go.
That's true.
So if you smell something and you immediately hear of this girl's or think of this girl's music, mm-hmm. that's brilliant.
Look at that.
You are literally manipulating people's psychology by doing that.
That's true. And music already is very, it can be intense with emotions. And emotion, heavy emotion, is what really ties in memory to make it strong. So yes, that scent is going to help tie into that emotion.
Absolutely. It's like when... Like I can smell it to this day, even just thinking about it. Like this cologne that my dad used to wear. And like every time I smell that, an image of my dad pops right in my head. Every single time. So if I smelled some like, you know, really fruity perfume or something coming off a record, mm-hmm. I'm always going to think of that every single time I smell that.
Let's press a vinyl that smells like dirt. It's Map the World. It smells like earth.
That would be brilliant.
Earth and music.
Did you know the map that's behind our new logo is a map of Mars?
Really?
Yes.
Hmm.
We're not the only world, guys.
That's true. A whole new world.
You could be a Disney singer.
I could, maybe.
Actually,
not for my songs before. Holy cow.
I would like to do one more song before we get out of here.
It's all good. Okay.
What do you want to do, Ryan? Do you want to do this box?
You did mention this box, and that's sticking to the EP, which is good.
It is. Or so, do you want to do something that's not on the EP?
What do you feel?
You have any new prog? What was it? Knight's,
Oh, is this that little...
Knight's Interlude, is it?
It's a King's
Interlude.
Yeah, it's, Oh, I could do, I could do King's Interlude into, like, pieces.
Sure. Have at it.
Yeah, so I've been writing lots. Lots and lots and lots. Like I said, I've had a lot of time to think about the music that I'm writing. So, let's see.
Somehow I picked up all the pieces.
trying to find a reason, never knowing why I don't really notice when everyone's not around. I don't really care as long as you make it somehow. Travel further than ever before, just to distance yourself from me. I tried to convince you it wasn't too smart to leave. Looking back, I can see the truth. The future has life to breathe. There's a whole new world made just for me. I don't really notice when everyone's not around. I don't really care as long as you make it somehow. Try to find a reason, never knowing why I don't really notice when everyone's not around. I don't really care as long as you make it somehow.
We'll be right back.
Yes, he is.
All silent instead of actually clap.
I did that for those watching on the camera up there. That was a special little treat.
It was a special little treat.
For you visual viewers.
Hey, listen. Visual? I didn't think that we were ever going to use that song, ever.
No?
And I think we're going to.
There you go. You heard it here first.
Because, you know, this whole post-rock thing, we are post what we were doing, so...
That's true.
It does make sense that we are called post-rock.
We are after the boulder.
Yes. So all the new stuff, like, all of our new stuff going forward is going to be very instrumental. Like, instrumental. Lacking words. All the stories are going to be told with the instruments. And that's the main focus at this point. The main focus is to stay in a zone where we can... Focus fully on one thing apiece. Because I know that... it's a struggle for me to sing while I'm playing guitar. It's a struggle for Matt to sing while he's playing drums. It's a struggle for Ryan to sing when he's playing bass. It's very easy to get caught up in trying to sing and screw up what we're doing and not be able to feel it all the way. And right. you really fall out of the groove doing that. And I think that if we just... I can't say that we're staying within our comfort zone. I think that we've found our specialty in med school, and now we're going to go for it. I think that's where we're at.
We were undecided.
We were undeclared for a while.
All right.
And then we were doing, you know, the pre-med whatever crap, and, you know, now we're going for brain surgery.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Metaphors.
Yeah.
There's nothing wrong with that.
Nothing wrong with that at all. I think that, hashtag brains. Brains! What is this? Metaphor. Metaphors! Metaphors? Ooh. But yes, again, we are Map.
Song name?
Map the World.
Map the World.
We also go by Delineate the Terrasphere. What was the other one?
Cartograph the globe.
Yes, cartograph the globe.
How did those come about?
Because they're just
synonyms.
Synonyms for map the world.
Synonym roles.
Yes.
Just like grammar used to make.
I'm gonna have a lot of those synonym roles tomorrow. You.
I like that though. That was a good way.
This guy is like, he'll slip in his puns wherever he can. Anywhere he can. He is like the pun master. He holds back a lot, I think.
Maybe.
I think that he is so fluent in puns that he's just fluent in not using them. And he's just like, you guys are just full of crap all the time.
Now you have to write a song on puns.
And Ryan has to sing it.
And use puns.
Yeah.
And you can write it.
Call it punderstated. I have no idea. I'm just making this up as I go along.
Pun suppression.
Pun suppression. That's pun surprising.
Like that. I like this idea.
It's punny.
Yeah.
See, no one took it yet. No one took it yet. I had to.
Oh, man. This has been a good time.
It has. We should get out of here before we kill this guy.
Yeah. Not... Wait, what?
Yeah.
Not literally.
Why? No.
Not literally.
Don't worry, the crowd's waiting.
Yeah, stay tuned for that fantasy draft. That sounds like a lot of fun, right?
Fantasy draft? What, is it like a weekly like re-up for football? Is that what it is?
No, basketball.
No. Oh.
They decided to do up. Because we've been doing, what, fantasy football for, what, 4 years now? I want to say. So now actually going into basketball. Even though the bad thing is basketball's already started.
That's true. Well, that just means people kind of have a lead on where they want to go, who they want to draft.
Exactly. Everybody wants LeBron. Everybody wants Kyrie. Everybody wants Tristan. Like, everybody wants the Cavs. That's what it is.
Just draft the Cavs.
I actually have two already. Because I actually got another league.
Yeah, like, that's what I'm telling you. Everybody wants the Cavs. Everybody wants Golden State. Like, that's what everybody wants.
I couldn't help it.
But you know what?
Golden State blew a 3-1 lead.
So did the Indians.
Hey, whoa.
I understand. I understand. Trust me. I'm the biggest Indians fan in the world.
Oh, man.
We can't talk like that anymore.
Not anymore. That's probably all that talk.
Yes, that is why we lost. I was at game 6, man. It was horrible.
The problem is
horrible.
Before it even got into that series, it was somebody out on Facebook already saying, "What was it?
What, the parade?
Yeah, the parade." Yeah, the parade.
Well, no, because now there's the Browns perfect season 0-16 parade that's being planned. So I'm totally going to that.
We might make that one. We're close.
I know. Here's the problem. If we get a win, then we lose the first draft pick. Mm-hmm. So we need to lose all 16
Possibly
games.
Possibly not. But the bad thing is I see them trading back.
Mm.
I don't see us keeping the number one, even if we get it.
Well, regardless.
We'd probably trade the number one draft pick for like 3 8th round draft picks. Because we're the Browns.
Probably. Because you know what? They're so afraid. They're so afraid of getting stuck with another RG3 or Johnny Football or just another cancer. Like, they've been getting stuck with cancer for the last, I don't know, 16 years.
But the thing is,
the problem is,
we drafted good players. And we just tanked them. Yeah. You're saying, like, RG3 was a bad player before, like, Johnny Manziel was a bad player before.
Well, he got train wrecked in Washington.
Yeah.
Yes, he got train wrecked. And Johnny Manziel was a train wreck.
All of these players that we drafted, though, Peyton Hillis, Brady Quinn.
Peyton, okay.
No,
Colt McCoy.
Peyton Hillis.
All these people were supposed to be the... Oh, what?
Yeah. We didn't draft him.
Either way.
Because he came from Denver.
We had all this potential, and we tanked it.
Yes. I mean,
but I am still a Browns fan.
I'm not. I haven't been a Browns fan in years, and there's no. I have almost no interest in football.
I'm a masochist.
I have almost no interest in football unless it's Ohio State, and I don't even watch that anymore because I know they're going to win. They're going to have a winning season every single year. I will watch it if they're in their bowl, but I don't watch it anymore. I didn't even go to Ohio State. I was raised on Ohio State, watching it every week. You know, I went to Kent State. Like, I should be a Golden Flash, but I'm a Buckeye.
Well, the problem is with first-round picks and that, we always blow up on quarterbacks going to the Browns.
Exactly. Yeah. That's why we go through quarterbacks like nothing.
If it's either a first, third, or second. The problem is we get in a season, doesn't work out, fans chant, we force them in. This year, don't draft a quarterback with the first two rounds.
You know what? We need a good halfback.
O-line.
We need a good halfback. Somebody that can grab the ball and jump over the line.
Not like that can run the...
We need another Peyton Hillis. That's what we need. We need another Peyton Hillis.
And someone that can run at light speed. That the line doesn't, can just, snap the ball, make contact, and the person's gone.
0-70 in .5.
Nothing.
Yeah. See? I already thought of this. But that's the problem since we came back. We always draft a quarterback. People force them in.
Well, because everybody wants to see an all-star quarterback. Because you have these teams like the Cowboys who have Tony Romo. You have the Pats who have Tom Brady. You have...
Aaron Rodgers for the Packers.
Yes.
But the huge problem is right now...
Cam Newton and...
They actually have a line. We don't.
For years and years and years, you had John Elway. You know, I mean, you have these key players that are immortal, and Cleveland doesn't have that. And that's what they're searching for. They're searching for their immortal quarterback because that's who's going to lead their team. And they cannot find one that wants to be in Cleveland.
You mean that wasn't Tim Couch?
He looked good after, the third year.
I mean, Tim Couch was at least consistent enough to be around for a while.
Except his first year that he ended up, 50-something sacks.
Oh, gosh.
He got pretty much beat up.
Back to the O-line.
So, yeah.
But I think Colt McCoy would have been...
He had squat.
A decent... He was a decent prospect for... I mean, his college numbers were amazing.
Well, no, he had squat as in wide receivers and that when he was here. He had squat to work with, literally.
Yeah. But, he was the star in college, and that's, like... And that's the problem, is they take these college kids and throw them right into the show, like, immediately, like, as a starter. And
the fans force it.
I mean, it worked for Tebow for a while, but... It's not the ideal thing to do. It really isn't.
But there's your perfect example. That's what's wrong with the Browns. Except Cole.
The lack of consistency in the front office is what's wrong with the Browns.
And while the fans also forcing the young quarterbacks into the action within the first year. We're guilty.
It's all our fault.
It's we, the Clevelanders. Could you name one quarterback that we drafted within the first two rounds that we didn't force in the first season to the field? Name me one time.
No.
But then you look at Aaron Rodgers, sat behind Brett Favre, you know, what, 2-3 years?
Yeah. Well, they had Brett Favre.
So. But at least his first year in the league, he didn't touch the field, except preseason.
Yeah, he was getting pointers from the superstar.
Then here and there, you see them in different flashes. You know, Brett got hurt. Name one time we actually did that.
Right.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, that's why the list of quarterbacks down the jersey is down to the back of your knees.
What, 25, 26?
Yeah.
I don't know. I lost count.
Like, dude, you gotta wear a dress to be able to put all the names on the back of the shirt.
Growing. Just almost for the a wedding dress. Season.
Just for, yeah, exactly.
Not to really name how many times we had to either have someone in an x-ray room that was a quarterback, MRI. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's a really bad thing this year.
Injuries.
Winjuries.
Injuries. Do you see that Carlos Santana in, I think it was game 3, faked that injury on second base? He faked an injury to stall the game. He faked an injury. He's like, oh, man, ah! Like, because he slid into second base, and it looks like he really messed up his knee. And, like, he's just like, he calls time, and the coaching staff comes out, and he's just, like, limping around in the outfield. And then I'm like, dude, Carlos is such a baby. Like, if he's really hurt, he's going to get out of the game. He will be out of the game within the next 2 minutes. They stall it for, like, 5-6 minutes, okay? Back on base like it's nothing.
Yeah. They just throw off the flow.
Throw off the pitcher.
Yeah.
And the pitcher's just standing there like this. Like, the whole time, just watching, like, this is bullcrap.
Come on, man.
Like, come on. Get back on the base.
Come on.
Or get out. Do one of the things. One of those things you got to do right now.
Baseball is an interesting sport.
Dude, baseball is so dramatic, and everybody's like, oh, baseball's boring. Like, do you, like, dude, soap operas are boring, but they're dramatic.
True. But, yeah. Going on that Lahungi rant, yeah. What, music to like sports. 10-minute, you know, sports segment into this?
Yeah.
Right. Well, it's a good segue into your next show.
We're diverse.
Something like that.
Yeah, we are diverse. See, I'm a hardcore Indians fan. He likes the Browns and basketball. And
yeah.
So, we're pretty diverse. All of it. Yeah. My faith is to the gods of baseball.
The baseball gods.
The baseball gods.
Nice.
They giveth and they taketh away.
Apparently, it was the Cubs' turn.
Mm-hmm. We'll get it. I guarantee by next year.
Guarantees or your money back.
Guarantees or my money back. What about
I'd
the
take on that deal?
What about the 28 years I've been waiting for? Can I get those back?
No, those are gone forever.
Well, you look at the Browns.
Those years are gone forever too.
Yeah, yeah, those years are gone.
Squandered.
Forever.
Literally. Welcome to our life.
Squandled.
Squandled.
Well, I always said after the Cavs, I said if the Cavs end up winning it all, this is what's going to happen. The fans are going to get ticked. They're going to go down Bird Brown Stadium.
Except no, see, here's the thing about Cleveland, and I've noticed this in the past couple
months.
That would
have been the right thing to do.
And this is not only the thing about Cleveland, it's about Americans, okay? You know when Hillary Clinton called Donald Trump's people deplorables and they, like, latched onto it, okay? It's like Cleveland is latching onto this perfect season.
They're like, you know what, if we're going to suck...
We're going to suck really bad.
But really good.
And we're going to get wasted after. And, like, that's... Dude, that is the American dream right there. Embracing everything that comes your way, embracing, good or bad.
Embracing mediocrity.
Embracing mediocrity.
Well, we've been doing that since 99.
We're not even mediocre in football.
No, that's true. I'm just an optimist.
Well, I've always been saying this within the past 2 years. It's almost like that... The Browns are like that really bad kid at sports in Pee Wee. They sit there.
He's like the kid in class that nobody likes.
Not that. But, you know, they're a really bad kid in sports and that you feel bad, but you cheer for him anyway.
Yeah, it's that pity cheers.
Yeah.
We've been pity there. Cheers.
Well, there you go.
Dude, it's really dark out there.
I know.
Like, in the halls. Did they lock us in the building?
No.
I think they did.
No, they didn't.
Are you sure?
Yeah, because it would be actually darker than that.
We're stuck here forever.
If it was actually shut down, because I've been here to that point, it would be darker than that.
Ryan,
out there.
I know you wanted to go back to Columbus, but I don't think you can today.
Columbus? Holy cow. That is a long drive from here. Holy Toledo.
All right. But let's go get some drinks, buddy.
Yep. Thank you guys for coming.
Thanks so much for having us on, man. It was a good time, for sure.